Hi, folks. I salute you in the name of Jesus Christ and the compliments of this season. I say happy holiday to every one of you and those of you who can really accommodate it. Merry Christmas to you. It is a joyful time, it's a joyful season, and it is word of celebration. And this is a time when good things are being done and good things are being said in remembrance of the birth of our Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Shall we pray? Lord, we thank you and we glorify your name, that the joy of this season that have filled all our hearts, O God, shall abide and continue to abide in us. We thank you for such a wonderful season, and we ask, Lord, that all that we will do shall be to the glory and to the honor of your name. May you grant joy to those who do not have, and may you also give them the ability to understand the reason for this season. We thank you, Holy Spirit, for everything that you are doing. In Jesus' name, with thanksgiving, come on, joyfully and cheerfully say a big amen. This is a joyful time, and this is a joyful season, because we have every reason to rejoice in a time like this. My sermon is going to be very, very brief, but I've entitled it, A Son is Given. Hallelujah. The Bible tells us in the book of Matthew chapter 1, verse 23, it said, "Behold, the virgin shall be with a child, and shall bring forth a son, and they shall call his name Emmanuel, which being interpreted is God with us." And then Isaiah chapter 9, verse 6, it says, "For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called." Go after me. Say, "Wonderful, wonderful. Counselor, the mighty God, the everlasting Father, and the Prince of Peace." Hallelujah. So this verse speaks of it all. This son that was brought forth by a virgin, the Bible said his name shall be called Emmanuel, which means God with us. And at the same time, this same one son is also called the Wonderful, called Counselor, Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, and the Prince of Peace. Ladies and gentlemen, I just want to submit to you in this season that we are rejoicing, that the reason why the whole world is full of joy at this moment is just because of this one son. He said, "Unto us a child is born, but unto us as well a son is given." A son is not only just born, but is given. Having a son in a family is a very good, it's a very powerful something. More especially coming all the way from the African context, where male issues are being valued so much. And when you are married and you have not yet gotten a son in the family that married you, it's like you've not really had a legal stand. Are you hearing me, somebody? So son is being looked at, the career of the father's name, and they are being looked at an emblem of significance, an emblem of loyalty, an emblem of solidity. Are you hearing me? Something that is so solid, that is like unmovable. That's the way sons are being looked upon. But to have a son which is being given is something extraordinary. Many families still have sons or give birth to sons, and yet those sons have not brought any joy to that family, because they are just being born. They are not being given. Are you hearing me? But here we are talking about a child that is being born, and that a son is being given. A child can be born, but a son is not just only being born. A son is being given. When you get a gift, now listen to me. To be given means it is a past participle of the word, the verb, to give, which in the dictionary meaning depicts to present voluntarily and without expecting any compensation, or to bestow onto somebody, or to hand over onto somebody, or to place in somebody's care, or to grant permission to somebody. So what we are seeing here is that A son is being bestowed to us. A son is being granted to us. A son is being given unto us voluntarily by God without any compensation. Are you hearing me, somebody? So when a gift is being given to you, and it's being given to you without you, you know, paying anything for it, it is too beautiful. Many children come to the world, but they don't really bring joy. Many children come to the world, they don't just bring that which is accomplishing. But here we see that this only one son that was being given, or that was being born or brought forth by this virgin. This virgin that was betrothed, that was being engaged to be married, and all of a sudden the husband found out that this woman was carrying a baby in the stomach without his knowledge, and the husband wanted to separate from her. But the angel appeared, angel Gabriel appeared, and said, "Don't try what you want to do. Don't ever try it, because this one is not just a child that is inside, but it's a child that is being, you know, conceived out of the Holy Ghost. This child is going to be extraordinary. One thing that is going to mark the existence of this child is that he's going to bring joy when this child is being given." Amen. This child, when he's being given to the world, is going to be called Emmanuel, which means God has come to be with us here on earth. And we know very well that when God comes in any situation, the situation becomes very, very enjoyable. It becomes very, very endurable. It becomes that which can be joyfully seen. So for God Almighty to give us such a precious gift, the only begotten Son, who assumed the form of a child and came down to earth to reconcile humanity with God, is something so powerful. It gives every person the reason to be rejoiceful. It gives us every reason to be joyful. It gives us every opportunity for us to be glad that we, who were very far from God because of sin, who were separated, now cannot come close because somebody paid the price. That's why he's called Emmanuel, the God with us, who left all his throne and came down to the earth to assume the nature of a human being, even a babe, you know, to be born by just a mere woman. It is something very extraordinary. And the Bible says that son is being given as a gift to humanity. We do not merit it. We do not deserve to have the type of Jesus. We do not, because of our sinful nature. But he came down anyway to be given to us as a gift. Hallelujah. To be given to us to enjoy. To be given to us to fellowship. Let me tell you, ladies and gentlemen, the fact is that when you have a baby boy, and this baby boy is the type that is real, very good. Let me give you qualities of a good baby boy that's supposed to make you happy. A good baby boy, a good son, must be obedient to his parents. That means you just have to do what the parents would want you to do, even when it has to do with choosing the sort of peers or the sort of cliques you must have to work with. This son doesn't need to deviate from what the parents want. Why? Because parents have the right, they have an inner eye that sees, they see beyond that child. So when a son has been given to a family, the son begins to grow. Of course, you will go to school and want to mingle with people, but it's the parents who determine, who say, no, I don't like this particular one. Don't bring this boy back to our home. I don't want this one. You can move with this one. So when that child is full of obedience, the child may love that one that the parents do not want him to move with, but this child have to obey. So every good son obeys the parents, more especially the father figures. Every good son obeys the father and obeys the mother. And that we saw in the life of Jesus Christ. We also see that another quality of a good son is that every good son would have would know how to be loyal. You be loyal, and when you are loyal, you will be faithful to the core. You see, you are loyal even when something is not the way it's supposed to be, but you see that every good son is loyal to, you know, to honor and to value the things the parents value and to respect the things the parents respect. They do not tell lies. They will prefer not to lie than to tell lies. How many good sons do we have today who will prefer not to lie to the parents? Look at what is happening all over the world today. People's children are carrying bombs and killing themselves without even the parents knowing. Would you say that these are good sons? Would you say that they are loyal? Would you say that they are obedient to their parents? No. These are sons who have grown and have become like wild grapes, and they do not bring good taste to the family. But in this one son that was given to us by God, we saw the emblem of loyalty. We saw the emblem of obedience. Jesus obeyed God the Father even unto death. For Jesus to leave the throne in heaven and to come down, to assume the nature of mankind, is something every man listening to me have to think and ask himself, do you have the emblem of Christ in you? Are you as humble as Jesus? Are you as loyal as him? Are you very, very obedient to your parents as the man Jesus? That is the reason why we are rejoicing. Because he came and he really made a public show of all the wicked deeds of the enemy. You see, the devil is full of arrogance and Jesus is full of humility. The devil is full of disobedience and Jesus is full of obedience. The devil is full of rebelliousness and Jesus is full of what? Loyalness. So if a son is given to a family, that son becomes a source of joy, not only to that family, but also to the entire humanity. And that's what Jesus is to all humanity. When you look at the streets of Amsterdam and you look at the streets all over the world, you see all the lights glittering. You see joy in the faces of the people. Oh, yesterday I just took time. I said, let me just walk a little bit out of the street. I saw no single soul and I was wondering. I said, these streets used to be too busy. I walked straight and until I got to Amsterdam Support, which is really the downtown of Amsterdam South Oost, you could just see roughly maybe about 5 people along the way. This is a street that used to be jam-packed with people. I said, wow, what a celebration that the whole world is celebrating one son that is given to the earth. One son that left the throne of heaven to come down to earth to assume the nature of a man. God, we will continue to celebrate this season and we will continue to be joyful that a son is given to the world. Hallelujah. A son is given to reconcile humanity with God. A son is given to bear the government of the earth upon his shoulder. A son is given, you know, to endure all the hardship which we would have endured. Come on, say a big amen. Jesus did it all for us and for us alone. Hallelujah. When you have a good son at home or in a family, it becomes a source of joy. This son doesn't just think about himself. This son is very, very sacrificial. The son which we are talking about becomes very, very respectful, not only to parents, but also to all the elders. How many of the sons that were born by us are respectful? But if it is a son that is given, I'm not just only preaching and talking to those who have sons that they have begotten, but who bore son. I'm talking about a son that is given. The son that is given is a gift. The one that is being born is just a son to you. But the one that is given becomes a gift to humanity, a gift to the whole earth, a gift to all that is around. Are you hearing me? That is the reason why this season is full of joy. Because a son is given, is joyfully given out by God for the earth to take and to rejoice. little wonder there is too much of joy all over the earth. Full of respect, full of loyalty, and full of obedience. Every good son spends time with the parents. Every good son spends time with the parents, not only the parents, but also with those that are very, very, very close to him. Good sons spend time. And we know that many times Jesus will go to solitary place just to go and seek the face of the Father and try to know the mind of the Father. And then when he knew the mind of the Father, he executes it on earth. Throughout the 3.5 years Jesus lived on earth, he just only was doing the will of the Father. He was only looking for a way to do what will please the Father. He was just only, you know, doing things that will make the Father very, very, very happy. He spent a lot of time hearing the plans of the Father for the earth, working in accordance to do what the Father would want to be done here on earth. After all, that was the reason why he left heaven and he came down to earth. So he came down to earth not to do his own will, but to do the will of the Father. So every child, every son that is being given doesn't just satisfy himself, but rather he tries to listen to the parents to know what is he that can. He spends time with the parents. He tries to know what they love. He tries to help them. He tries to guide them. Not like the arrogant sons of this time, whereby when your father cannot meet up with the Facebook and the LinkedIn technology, you they laugh, ha 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 ha. They laugh. Oh, he's an outdated, he's an old man. But a good son that is given takes time to even teach the parents of the latest technology. He spends time to teach them, to make sure that he communicates well with the parents. So Jesus spent all his time. He was spending time to know what will be the will of the Father. How can I execute this will? How can I please you, Daddy God? How can? A good son who that is given expresses gratitude. Today, we have so many children, after they have been trained by their parents, who suffered to give birth to them, who suffered to send them to school, who denied themselves of their comfort just to make sure that they are sent to school. These kids come out ignoring their parents. These kids come out looking down upon their parents. Their father become a wizard and their mother become a witch. Oh, such a vagabond. That one, I can't call that one a son, but a vagabond. But we are looking and congratulating those who are giving. When a child is giving, the child becomes very, very, very grateful to all that the parents have done for him. The child shows gratitude all the time. What can I do to make my parents happy? These parents who sent me to school, these parents who denied themselves of their comfort, how would I be a blessing to them in their old age? A son that is given to a family makes sure that he keeps his parents, you know, going on. He makes sure he makes the parents happy, and he extends that joy and that gratitude to other people, other folks who are friends to the family and friends to the parents. They are full of gratitude. Little wonder we always see Jesus, all his prayer, full of gratitude. Lord, I thank you. Father, I thank you for these ones you've given to me. Father, I thank you that it is your will that has to be done. Father, Jesus was full and is full of gratitude. Even when he was going through some process, Jesus never insulted God the Father. Jesus Christ still obeyed even to the last minute. So a son that is being given doesn't bring sorrow. That son brings joy. That son shows gratitude all the time. Today, we have so many folks who cannot say thank you to their parents. We have so many sons who are just born, but they are not given. Yes, of course, they are not given, because if they are given as a gift, the family will be rejoicing. But they are just born because, yes, somebody must be born. So they came out. And they are causing a lot of sorrow, causing a lot of agony, and acting as if they were just Iroko 3 that came out. If you are that type of a son, I challenge you to repent. Be a child that is given. Be a son that is given. When you are being given by God, you will not make your parents to agonize. When you are being given by God, you will not bring sorrow to the society. When you are being given by God, you will make everyone around you to know that you are a gift. Gifts are not supposed to make people sorrowful. Gifts are not supposed to make people to become arrogant. Gifts are not supposed to make people angry. Gifts are supposed to make people joyful. When I'm not expecting something and it's being given to me and it's exactly what I want, I will dance, I will rejoice, and I rejoice, and I rejoice. I will jump and jump, and I will call other people and say, hey, look at such a gift which I got. But if you, instead of being a gift, you are now becoming like a thorn in the flesh, then something is wrong. I pray that Jehovah will help you to have the characteristics of Jesus Christ. That is the son that was being given by God to humanity. Hallelujah. Good sons take time to listen to their parents and those who are close to them. Do you listen to your parents? When you are a gift that have come to the family, you will not ignore the parents. You will not ignore your parents. You will not feel hesitant to listen to them. Even when they are old and they are not speaking the language you expect them to speak, you will still put your ear very close. You want to listen. Even when your parents did not go to school and you have now graduated from Harvard University and you can speak better English more than them. I love what my father was always saying when he was alive. My father would say, hey, baby, I bought that English you are speaking. So when you are speaking that English to me, your daddy, make sure you use the right words and address me properly. Don't salute me like any of your boyfriend. Just say, daddy. You know, yes, daddy, answer that way. Don't just answer me like any of your friends. Because I bought the English you are speaking. And I was wondering, how can he always be saying this? But down the line, I have come to realize that what he was saying was right. If he didn't send me to school and he didn't send my siblings to school, would we be speaking the English we are speaking? We will maybe end up just speaking the vernacular, the language of the place where we were born. But for us to be speaking a foreign language, which is besides the vernacular, it means that somebody must have bought it and no other person but him. Hallelujah. Because God gave him the grace to be able to send us his children to school. What I'm trying to say is that no matter how illiterate your parents may be, no matter how uneducated your parents may be, a true mark of a son that is given is that he listens to his parents. He listens. He takes time to listen. What is my daddy trying to say by this? What is my mom trying to say by this? He doesn't just get up and do things anyhow and cause a whole havoc to the family. He doesn't distort what is ongoing in that family. Rather, he tries to build up. Even when he has correction to make, he doesn't just come to abandon all the old, but he just tries as much as he can to incorporate the old and the new. That is how we know when sons are being given to a family. When good sons are being given to a family, they don't become source of sorrow. They don't become source of agony. They don't become source of poverty. They don't become source of a negligence. Rather, they are bundles and bundles of blessing. Jesus Christ is a bundle of blessing to humanity. Little wonder the scripture tells us in the book of Philippians chapter 2, verse 5 and 7, the Bible said, let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus, who being in the form of God, thought it not robbery to equal with God, but made himself of no reputation and took upon him the form of a servant and was made in the likeness of men. And being found in fashion as a man, he humbled himself and became obedient unto death, even the death of the cross. Wherefore, God also hath highly exalted him and given him a name which is above every name, that at the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow, of things in heaven and things in earth and things under the earth, and that every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. This is the reason for the season. This is the reason why we have abundant joy at this time. He said, let the mind which is in Christ be in us. The mind that made him not to rub shoulder with the Father. The mind that made him to even go and die on the cross of Calvary as a, like a thief. The mind that made him, you know, to leave the throne of heaven and come down and assume the nature of a babe. Let that mind be in us. Ah, this is why no one can compare with Jesus and no one can be equal to Jesus. He is the superstar. He is the Emmanuel, the God with us. He is the reason for the joy that is in all our faces. As you go through this whole season and the year is almost coming to an end, always remember that the joy of this season is just because of that son that is given. For unto us a child is born, and unto us a child is being given. A son is being given. He is that son of God that is being given for a season like this. May you enjoy the qualities that is in him. May all attributes that is in him as well be seen in you, so that you also can become an emblem of joy in your situation. I want to thank God for your life, and I want to bless him for all who have really, really been giving to their families. Those of you who are really giving, I pray that you will do more and more and continue to be a source of joy to your family and to your environment. Never, never give up because you are being given. God knows why it is you that is in that family. God, sometimes, you know, when you are being given, it is like the burden is too much. Let me tell you one thing. The Lord who have given you to be a gift to that family and to that nation and to that generation at a time like this, he knows that you are capable of, you know, fulfilling everything that he would want you to fulfill. Don't ever feel that you are lonely. Don't ever feel that you are alone. Don't ever feel that the job is too much for you alone and you want to compete to be like other siblings. Other siblings may only be born, but you are the one that is being given. And because you are the one that is being given, oh, God will give you the strength to fulfill the desire and to fulfill the assignment that he has called you to do. May Jehovah bless you. May the Lord keep you. May he cause all things to work together for good to you who is given. Not only to those who are born, but I'm talking to those who are given. To you who is given, let Jehovah be your portion and continue to be a blessing even to your generation. This is where I am ending this broadcast this hour, and I trust that you have been blessed. Once again, enjoy this season. Enjoy it and enjoy it to the fullness. And God richly, richly bless you. Thank you.